Sergeant Preston of the Northwest Mounted Police with Yukon King, swiftest and strongest lead dog breaking the trail in the relentless pursuit of lawbreakers in the wild days of the Yukon. Back to the days of the gold rush as Sergeant Preston with his wonder dog Yukon King meets the challenge of the Yukon. This is the Yukon, the territory patrolled by Sergeant Preston. In winter, its northern valleys and forests rich in furs, a valuable national asset when properly conserved. The Mackenzie River country, still largely unexplored, was the greatest prize of all. Here the Indian, pushed remorselessly north by the encroaching white trappers, struggled to retain his hunting grounds, source of his food and clothing, without which he must die of privation. To prevent such bloodshed, the government offered the tribes a treaty of land rights, making certain areas off limits to the trappers. A powwow between Indian and government lasted through the short summer. As the new snows swirled down from the Arctic, an agreement was reached, needing only the High Commissioner's signature to bring peace again to the land. With no time to waste, Inspector Fitzwilliam led a patrol south from Fort McPherson to Blackstone Crossing with the precious treaty. Accompanying him on the dangerous 350-mile run were Constables Ted Rowe and Dempsey. They would pick up Little Moose, an Indian guide, at the river bend. Later, on the heels of a paralyzing blizzard, Sergeant Preston drove 150 miles north from Dawson with his great dog King on orders to meet Fitzwilliam at Blackstone Crossing and relay the treaty back from that point.
Well, if it isn't Pete Dexter.
Hello, Swede.
Seen anything yet? Any word?
Nothing, Narvik. You sure you didn't dream this up?
Don't dream. Got it straight from Indian Joe. The treaty was almost concluded when we left the fort. Fitzwilliams will bring it in, you can bet on that.
Maybe he got caught with that last storm. Maybe he's dead on the trail somewhere.
You better hope so. Those trapping grounds are the best you and Ben ever had. Indians take him over. You're finished, Dexter.
You too, Narvik. You'll never get rich off what these boys around here bring in.
That tree must never reach Dawson. If that Mountie patrol managed to get across the divide...
We're done for. The trail from here to Dawson will be a cinch for them.
Maybe.
What do you mean by that?
You're stopping them and destroying that treaty.
You want me to gun down the Mounties?
Hang or starve, you're just as dead either way.
Pete Dexter was a master at the various forms of Indian wrestling.
Come on, Pete. Come on.
Well, which one of you boys care to take up where this tadpole left off? It appears to me as if I left all the men back to the Mackenzie country.
Here's your man for Indian wrestling, Dexter. Sergeant Preston.
Mounty, eh? Well, now I'd be delighted. How about it, Sarge? Think you're man enough?
I'm here on more important business, Mr.
Dexter. Pete Dexter. Not scared, are you, Sarge?
No, not exactly, Dexter.
Go on and show him, Sergeant.
I heard you mention the Mackenzie country. Is that where you're from?
No, Sarge. I don't think I'll tell you anything till I see how much of a man you are.
Very well. You ready?
Ready.
Come on, Sergeant. Well, now, Dexter, if you'll answer my questions.
Now, who in thunder's that?
Snow blind. Little moose.
Patrol. Lost. Bend. Big Wind River. Patrol.
Make a saline solution, will you, Narvik? It leaves the pain in his eyes.
Sure, right away, Sergeant.
Well, what do you think? Looks to me like only the engine got through.
We're still not safe, if that's what you're thinking. It's Williams' no Chichaco. He might make a jet. He's tough.
And if he doesn't?
We're still not out of the woods. Only Sergeant Preston hadn't shown up.
You don't think Preston would go searching for the party, do you?
Sure, I do. But that smart dog of his, he's liable to make it. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless you do something about it.
Me? Now listen, Narvik.
Quiet. Let's get back before Preston thinks we're up to something.
Don't try to talk anymore. I understand everything now. Try to get some rest as soon as I've taken care of your eyes. Thanks, Narvik. And he'll be all right after a little rest. Now, if you men will follow me into the store, I have something to tell you. Men, I was sent to meet a patrol out of Fort McPherson, led by Inspector Fitzwilliams. This patrol is carrying a document of vital importance to everyone in this territory. I was to meet the patrol here. Take the document on to Dawson. According to Little Moose, patrol is lost. I must find these men, and I'll need help. According to the guide, Little Moose, he became separated from the rest of the group near the Big Wind River crossing, and he never saw them again. Now, which direction Fitzwilliams took from there is anybody's guess. You men know this country, and you know that this is a dangerous trip. I'll need some one man to accompany me. Who'll volunteer? Raise your hands. Well, it's hard to choose one from so many good men.
Sergeant, I'd like to make a suggestion.
Put your hands down, men. Thanks. Yes, what is it?
Sergeant, you're in luck. Dexter here knows the North Country as well as Little Moose. He's a fine woodsman and guide. He's the best man for you.
Well, you know these men better than I do, Narvik. What about it, Dexter?
I'm your man, Sarge.
Good.
With no existing maps to go by, Preston drew one of his own, combining information received from Little Moose, Dexter's knowledge, and his own prodigious memory.
Well, there you are, Dexter. What do you think of that?
I can't say I'm much of map reading, Sarge. Never had much education. But you take me up there and I'll make out fair enough. Don't worry.
Well, it might help if I give you a few checkpoints right here. This is the Big Wind River here. Now, you get down, King. You can't read maps. And this is the Mackenzie River right here. This checkpoint is where Fort McPherson is.
Looks clear to me, Sergeant.
It looks about right, Sarge. I'd say you meant this for the Mackenzie Mountains, right?
Right. Now, according to Little Moose, this is approximately the route that Fitz took. They must have come up the Peel River to the Trail River, then across Caribou Born Country to Mountain Creek, then on down to the Big Wind River. When the blizzard hit him on the divide, this is where Fitz and Little Moose parted company.
Tears clear enough to me.
Now, if we're lucky, we should pick up Fitz's trail somewhere between the Big and Little Wind Rivers.
Well, which way do you figure to go?
We'll go down the Blackstone River, then overland to Cache Creek, and down to Michael Creek. From there, down to the Little Heart River. Well, from there on to the divide, I'm a bit hazy.
Well, I believe I can help you there, Sarge. We can pick up the Big Heart from there and follow it to Wolf Creek. From Wolf Creek, it's just a hop and a jump over the ridge to Forest Creek. And that'll take you to the Little Wind.
Good. We'll need additional supplies.
I'm glad to accommodate you, Sergeant. Fortunately, I'm well stocked.
Good. I'll leave Little Moose here with you, Narvik.
I'll take good care of him.
We should be able to start by daybreak. Well, King, let's feed and bed the team down. Come on.
In the gray gloom of dawn, the fresh supplies lashed onto his sled, Sergeant Preston waited with King for his companion on the long trek north.
Hello, Dexter!
Stop worrying, Dexter. You may not have to touch Preston. After that last blizzard, finding the trail of the patrol is going to be like finding a needle in a haystack. Won't be the first time a lost patrol's never been found.
But what if Preston gets lucky?
Throw him off the trail. The longer you take, the better our chances you give up and come back empty-handed.
And if that doesn't work?
You know what to do.
You're a cagey one, Narvik. You're telling me to kill him, but not saying so.
If you locate the patrol, there's no other way, then kill him. And any survivor of the patrol. And destroy that treaty. And don't tell Preston we're partners. He might get suspicious.
Don't forget, Narvik. You're in this as deep as I am.
Well, King, we've a rough trip ahead of us. I wish I had as much confidence in men as I have in you.
Hey, Dexter, come on. We're wasting daylight.
Oh, put your shoes on the sled, Dexter. Ride the runners. I'll break trail for a while. You can take over later.
Okay, Sarge. You're the boss.
Hey, you ready?
On you, Huskies!
All gone out. Must stop Preston. Bad medicine. Him kill Sergeant.
Sergeant!
You're not going anywhere, Indian. Wouldn't want you wandering around out there in your condition.
Sergeant! Wait!
Across windswept divides and along tortuous river bottoms, Preston took his relief party, barely stopping to eat or rest. The Blackstone, Cache Creek, Michelle, Little and Big Heart, and on to Wolf Creek, Forest Creek, and the Ridge. Pushing north and east against biting gales and cold that froze one's very marrow. Not a footprint in the snow, not a sign of life, nor runner print to hearten them, to speed them on. And then the Little Wind River at last. And there...
nothing. Absolutely nothing on that river. Not even caribou tracks.
That's no use, Sarge. We've done our best. We might as well head for home.
Oh, Dexter... we're never sure that Fitz got this far. Little Moose said he lost him at the Big Wind River. Now we've come this far. We'll go on. And if you're tired, ride the runners. I'll break trail for a while. Well, King, you're going to have to carry a bit of an extra load, but you can do it. You're still the best man in this outfit. You ready? Let's go, boy.
Okay, ho, ho!
What's the matter? You spot something?
Maybe. Come here. Look, what do you make of it?
I don't see nothing.
Looks like an old trail. An old sled trail covered over.
This light plays funny tricks with a fella, Sarge.
Yeah, it leads right into those woods. Anyway, it's a good place to camp for the night. Maybe we can see it better in the morning.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go.
Sure looks like something. Come on, King. Come on. Hey, come back here.
Let him go, Sarge. You probably smell a rabbit.
That's more than a rabbit, Dexter. Come on.
Full business.
What is it, King?
Meat tins. And look what's stamped on the bottom.
NWMP.
Northwest Mounted Police. This was one of Fitz's camps, Dexter. We found it. Thanks to King.
Still don't tell us much.
No, but it will. I'll search this place thoroughly. There's bound to be more evidence about.
Well, you're busy. I'll go feed the dogs.
Dexter feared that King was getting too much to go on and might soon find the lost patrol. So he devised a delay by preparing the sled for an apparent accident.
Do you think you can make something of all this garbage?
I believe I can tell you exactly what happened in this last camp of Fitzwilliam's before he headed back for the fort.
Oh, go on.
Must have been bitter cold and snowing hard the night Fitz made camp here. Little Moose had disappeared. Fitz was lost. They knew it. One of the men already had badly frozen feet. Probably Constable Tedrow, the rookie at the fort.
How are the feet, Tedrow?
Swollen, Inspector. Left one's turning a bit black.
Well, I'll keep them tightly wrapped and well greased. I wish there was something more I could suggest.
I know, sir. I'll make out.
Good lad. Dempsey?
Ma'am, I've checked everything, sir. We've 10 pounds of bacon and a pound tin of tea left, and that's all.
May as well enjoy the last of the bully beef.
That carries through to Dawson, Inspector?
I doubt it. May as well know. After 3 days of searching, I've come to the conclusion that the iron ore around here is affecting the compass. Without Little Moose, any further search for the trail south to Sergeant Preston will be a waste of time. It's one thing we haven't got.
What are we going to do?
There's only one thing left to do. We're breaking trail back to the fort first thing tomorrow. We're lightening our load of all non-essentials. Stove, shotgun, fuel, anything we can spare.
But if we go back now, the treaty will be delayed for possibly months.
And if we die in this wilderness, nothing will be accomplished. The treaty will be lost forever along with us. Turning back, we stand a fighting chance.
That's the way Fitz would analyze the situation, and rightly. But Tedrow, the rookie, would look upon the retreat as a surrender to nature, and would be ashamed.
Seems almost like a surrender to an enemy, sir.
When you reach my age, my lad, you'll learn you never surrender to nature and live. But there are times when an armistice is good common sense.
And so it must have been. These discarded bandages may well lead us to that lost patrol.
You expect me to believe that, too?
There's a strong medicinal scent in these rags. King here has often tracked criminals across miles of rugged terrain. With nothing more than body scent on a blanket or handkerchief.
When the trail faded, Preston gave King his head, and the great dog unerringly led them on.
Oh!
That should be the Peel River, according to my calculations.
Maybe, maybe not. Never been this way before.
You know, for the past 3 days, you've been getting progressively more difficult to live with, Dexter. You admit you know more about this country than anyone else. But if it hadn't been for King, you'd have led us astray on several occasions. What's troubling you?
You must be getting trail fever, Sarge. Imagining things. Nothing wrong with me. Just made a few mistakes, that's all. Can't hold that against me, can you?
I suppose not. The King says the trail leads down into the valley, Peel or not. That's bad ice. I'll take the lead. You stay behind the sled and try to keep it from slipping off.
Dexter's plan to wreck the sled and team had failed, but he was partly successful. Preston, knowing of an abandoned cabin nearby, suggested they go there to check the damage and spend the night.
Dexter, the sled! Inspector! Inspector!
Go on. Fitz must have turned his dogs loose to forage for themselves. Look here. Someone fell and dragged themselves into the cabin. Probably the one with the frozen feet. Only 2 days from the fort. The food was gone, and they were weak from infection and undernourishment.
It's no use, sir. You should have left me back at the last camp. Why don't you leave me here while you still have a chance to make it to the fort?
Three of us came out of Fort McPherson, Tedro. Three of us going back.
The dogs, Inspector, shall I feed them?
We'll need what little food is left for ourselves. It's going to take all we can muster to make that last dash to the fort. Turn them loose to fend for themselves.
Yes, sir. Dash, sir?
That's the figure of speech, Constable. But walking or crawling, we're going to make it.
And I can almost hear old Fitz saying it, Dexter. What's the matter, fellow?
Broke.
No, wait, they're huskies. Fitz's dogs, ravenous enough to eat anything. They'll attack our dogs if we don't drive them off.
I'm not risking my life for a bunch of mutts.
Grab your gun and come on.
There they are, far over their heads.
On the run.
I must have been crazy to take this job. Didn't hanker for it in the first place.
And why did you volunteer?
It's a good question.
Down, fellas. Down. It's all right, boy.
Late afternoon the next day, Preston pushed his team hard down the valley of the Mackenzie when...
Wait, King, wait!
Dexter! Dexter, look! This must be blazing a trail. Look at the fresh marks in the snow. We've caught up with the patrol. Hope we're in time.
I am, Sarge. But you're not. This is as far as you go. Put up your hands.
What's the matter with you? We've caught up with the patrol. It's only a day's journey to the fort. The rest is easy.
Yep. Real easy. All I gotta do is pull the trigger and kill you and all of you die right here.
But why?
This is my trapping grounds. Mine and Ben and Narvik's. And no thieving Indians taking it away from us. So that means you gotta die. That treaty and the rest of this party will never reach Dawson, Sarge.
Quiet, hold it. Now turn around. You're under arrest. Now march for the back of the sled. Get in the sled. Put your hands behind you, one hand through the back bow. All right, King, we've still a job to do.
Within a day or two of salvation, and we can't even crawl. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which keepeth heaven and earth. He shall not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee shall not slumber. Behold.
Inspector! Inspector! Thank goodness we're in time, sir. Are you all right?
Sergeant Press, our prayers have been answered. Well done, Sergeant. Well done. The feat of Sergeant Press's rescue party will undoubtedly take its place in history. Thanks to prompt action, Inspector Fitzwilliam and Constables Tedrow and Dempsey are well on their way to complete recovery in Dawson Hospital. Little Moose, the guide who returned to Blackstone Crossing for aid, has received a commendation from the Northwest Mounted Police. Yesterday, Judge Bowman sentenced Trapper Dexter to a long prison term. Niles Narvik, the other conspirator, awaits sentence tomorrow. It is rumored that the High Commissioner now...
Good news, sir. At 1:45 this afternoon, the High Commissioner in person from Ottawa received and signed the Indian Land Treaty.
That is good news. And I shake the hand of a grateful man.
You're the one that deserves the credit, sir.
The same goes for you and King. And if I may say so, you two deserve most of the credit.
Well, we're all agreed and happy that this case is closed.